In the rapidly industrializing world, the one commodity which sees ever-increasing demand is, needless to say, energy. This is also the reason why fossil fuels like coal and petroleum has seen rapid decline in the recent years, with evident adverse impacts on environment. In view of this, India has made it mandatory to blend 5% renewable biofuel like ethanol with petrol and diesel. While biofuel blending in diesel is presently nil, the petrol blending today stands at an overall of about 3% in the form of first generation, that is 1G or molasses-based ethanol. The country plans to scale up the production of ethanol in the coming years. Along these lines, India has established its first 2G ethanol production plant with the aim of scaling up ethanol production. The plant was recently inaugurated in Kashipur, Uttarakhand, by the Union Minister of Science and Technology and Earth Sciences, Dr. Harsh Vardhan. The plant is based on the globally competitive indigenous feedstock independent technology developed by DBT ICT Center for Energy Biosciences at the Institute of Chemical Technology, Mumbai, supported by DBT and the Biotechnology Industry Research Assistance Council.
शायद यहीं से एक आने वाले समय के लिए वो नया इतिहास शुरू होगा, जहां अगली नई जनरेशन के लिए भी हम सबको उत्साह मिलेगा, इथेनॉल से ब्यूटेनॉल की तरफ जाने में भी उत्साह मिलेगा, और अभी जो केवल 3% हम पेट्रोल में ब्लेंडिंग कर पा रहे हैं, जिसका लक्ष्य आने वाले 5 साल के अंदर 20% तक है.
It has been a major impact on Uttarakhand and the economy, but also this is a company which has kept pace with technology, uses green chemistry in many of its aspects, and is adventurous in futuristic technology. This is rare, and the amplification of such an attitude by our industry can transform our country. There are no shortage of extraordinary solutions which are available from science and technology all over the world and from India. There are no shortage of problems which need to be solved in India, but this kind of an attitude from the private sector to experiment and take them forward is really vital.
The plant, with a capacity of 10 tons of biomass per day, works by converting lignocellulosic agricultural residues like bagasse, rice straw, wheat straw, bamboo, cotton stalk, corn stover, wood chips to ethanol in less than 24 hours. Ethanol blending in petrol increases the oxygen content in the fuel and ensures 100% clean combustion of petrol. This helps reduce vehicle exhaust emission to large extents. Apart from this, ethanol blending can also go a long way in reducing the import burden of crude petroleum, saving foreign exchange, fetching income to sugarcane farmers, along with protecting environment and opening up new avenues of employment.